Hi, this is Mike Berthold, Principal Solution Architect for Broadcom, and I'm going to be talking to you today about our new Health Monitoring REST API method in PAM 3.4. Basically, this is a new external REST API method that we've provided that can give you information on the status of your PAM nodes and clusters. And you can use this method to automate the health monitoring of your PAM environment. And so what does that mean? Basically, you're going to be able to look at your cluster status, your replication status, current hardware information usage, such as CPU, disk and memory utilization, the state of your network interfaces and your session recording mounts, and a couple of indicators on current number of out-of-sync passwords, logged-in users, and managed sessions in PAM. So let's take a quick look at how that looks within PAM. And so here I have a PAM environment. It's pretty simple, a two-host cluster. And you can see here in my dashboard, I can see the status of my two appliances, both CPU, RAM, hard disk, what your host names are, etc. And so basically what we're doing is we're externalizing this quick view in the dashboard via API. And so if you have your APIs enabled and we go to API doc, we'll actually be able to go ahead and test this out. And that's a nice thing about PAM is anytime that there's an API, you can begin your testing right here in the PAM client. And so I'm going to go ahead and show this new method dashboard. And there's just this one operation, cluster site info, and that's basically the new health monitoring REST API. And so I'm going to go ahead and try this out. I've already got my test account created. And once I successfully enter my authentication, I can see my response body, which is JSON, which shows this health data. Basically, right up front, you can see the request time and response time. Once we got the reply, we can get information on our hosts, and so here's my CAPAM2. We can see their network interfaces, and then further down we can see some information about our hardware, both CPU usage, disk usage, and memory usage. Our session recording status, so basically you can see we're mounted and everything's up and running. And that's great, but what can we do with this? And so the idea behind having this available in an API is to easily integrate with basically any external destination of this data. So if you already have your own SIM tool or some sort of web dashboard or application or monitoring app or anything else like that, it's really easy to integrate a REST-based API that basically provides information via JSON. And I'm going to show you a few of those examples right now. So I go ahead and minimize my client. So we're going to go ahead and actually we'll start with Postman before we get into Splunk. Postman is really typically ground zero if you're going to be doing API testing from outside. And so basically here I've already set up my URL here. I already have my authorization set up and authentication. And so I'm going to go ahead and just send this. And you're going to see exactly the same thing we saw in the API doc in the PAM client. I get my JSON back with all this information about my PAM environment. And that's great. But what about those external apps or solutions that we're talking about? And so I've also got a Splunk set up here. And so I really created a very simple REST API data source in Splunk. I didn't really do anything with it, but just to show you how easy it is to get the data in. And once you do that, then it's just a matter of basically using Splunk to create, whether it's monitoring, reporting, dashboards, alerts, etc. And so you can see basically all that information that you saw earlier is all here and ready to be used in Splunk. But I wanted to show you basically just how extensible this is. So what I did is I had some free time. We all do throughout this this environment that we're in, work from home, etc., to really see how far I could take this. And so what I did is I actually went ahead and created a sample or a application in VB.net. And it simply goes ahead, uses this API, pulls the information back, deserializes the JSON, and then presents it in whatever manner I see fit. And so what I've done here is it's a really simple health check where I can keep an eye on the environment. As soon as it loads, it actually runs the API and pulls the information back, shows me the host names, whether they're active or not, the hardware utilization, and you can see here I've actually coded green, yellow, red, depending on how heavy the usage is. And again, that's all parameters that I decided myself. And so that's just to give you an idea of just how far you can go with this. You can set up your own thresholds. You can set up alerting based on certain thresholds, etc. And so it really gives you the opportunity to externalize that dashboard view however you want, wherever you want, simply by leveraging the simple API. And you can see here, I can go ahead and refresh it, and it'll just pull back fresh data for me in about 3 seconds. And so that's just a quick tour of this new health monitoring REST API. Thank you for watching. Again, my name is Mike Berthold, and stay safe out there. Take care.